Good morning, students. I pray for you and your family's good health. Today's video is from your reader book of lesson number 7, A Scribe's Dream. Before reading and explaining you the lesson, let me tell you the story. Now, what do you mean by scribe? Scribe means a person whose job was to write copies of documents, especially before printing was invented. Scribe means a writer. It's a story of a poor and self-respected scribe who earned very less just to support his family but never borrowed any money from anyone. The scribe's greatest fear was that he would fall into the hands of a money lender. This fear was so strong that he happened to dream that he borrowed 100 gold coins from the money lender. This dream spread among the villagers and reached the moneylender's ears. The greedy and tricky moneylender asked the scribe to return him the money borrowed from him in his dream. Worried scribe went to Birbal to get him rid of this problem. Now let's read the lesson to know how Birbal solved the scribe's dream. A poor scribe finds himself in the clutches of a greedy money lender. Clutches means control of a greedy money lender who tries to trick him means cheat him into paying for a dream. The scribe and his wife turn to Birbal, the famous minister in Akbar's court. How will the wise and witty Birbal solve their problem? Witty, clever. Now let's see how scribe's problem got solved. There was once a poor scribe in the city of Agra who copied other people's writings and books. Nowadays there are printing presses. Earlier in the olden days there weren't any printing press. So a person naming scribe was assigned to copy books and copies of others. He earned nearly enough to support his family. But no matter how difficult it was, he and his wife always managed to feed means have a good meal themselves and their children. It means scribe was able to feed his family well with earning less or more money. The scribe was proud of the fact that he had never borrowed a single paisa. Borrowed means to take money from someone. We must never fall into the hands of the money lender. Means that we should never come under a situation to borrow money from any money lender, whether you have less or more. Try to fulfill your needs according to the pocket, or rather it means according to the money you are available with. He often told his wife. He told his wife that we must never fall into the hands of money lender. We should never borrow any money from anybody. For it we do, we will surely be ruined. If we borrow any money from anybody, we will be ruined, we will be destroyed. So we will never borrow any money from anyone. The scribe worried so much about his lack of money and his fear of borrowing that his worries even found a place in his dreams. Means he was so scared that he should never borrow any money from anybody, that's this fear even came in his dream. What was the dream? One night he dreamt that he had borrowed 100 gold coins from the money lender. He woke up in terror, in great fear, thinking, 100 gold coins? How could I repay such a large sum? Still trembling from his nightmare, he woke his wife and told her about it. Trembling means shaking. Nightmare means frightening dream. Repay means payback. When the scribe had a dream of borrowing 100 gold coins from the money lender, he woke up from the dream trembling and shaking from his dream and woke up his wife and told her that about the dream. They talked quietly for a while and soon the scribe felt better. He fell asleep once again. Realizing that it was just a dream, they went to sleep back again. The next day, as the scribe's wife drew water from the well at the end of the street on which they lived, she told her friends of her husband's dream. The next day, when scribe's wife met his friends, when she went for drawing water, she told about the scribe's dream to them. Imagine, she exclaimed, spoke surprisingly. He dreamt that we had borrowed not one or two, but 100 gold coins from the moneylender. Her friends laughed with her. A few of them thought it was a very good story and repeated it to their husbands when they got home. When the ladies went back home, they told their husbands the story of the moneylender's dream. Sorry, the scribe's dream of borrowing money from the moneylender. The story spread and a few days later it reached the moneylender's ears. He laughed when he heard it, but his eyes began to glitter greedily. When the moneylender heard that scribe has borrowed money from him in the dream, he started thinking of a trick. He was very selfish, very greedy. So his eyes started glittering, started having a trick in his mind. That evening, he put on his turban. Turban, you know what is turban? A long piece of cloth that is worn round the head. And picking up his walking stick, strolled over to the scribe's small house. Strolled over is walked to or went to the scribe's small house. "I have come," he announced to the nervous and worried scribe, "to remind you of the money you owe me. Owe me, have to pay." Now, the moneylender tried to befool those scribes to return the money they have borrowed from him in his dream. "Money?" squeaked the scribe in panic. "I owe you?" "Owe you" means spoke loudly. "Yes," answered the moneylender firmly. Firmly means strongly. 100 gold coins. Surely you have not forgotten. Means hopefully you have remembered that you have borrowed money from me. 100 gold coins? Gasped the scribe in a failing voice. It means with difficulty the scribe spoke, tottering to the nearest chair. While he was speaking shakingly or in nervous way, he went back and sat on a chair. Tottering means walking shakily. The scribe's wife, who had been listening from an inner room, came hurrying out. "But it was only a dream," she cried. "You cannot ask us to return money that has only been borrowed in a dream." Now when the scribe's wife heard about the moneylender's talk, he came out of his room and shouted at the moneylender that, "How can you ask for the money which we have dreamt about?" "Money is money," said the moneylender, "and money borrowed must be returned. Whether you borrowed money in real or borrowed money in a dream, you should repay my money back. You will have to start tomorrow. I am a good man, a kind-hearted man, and so I shall not demand it in all back at once." Means moneylender said, "I'm a good person, no worry, you people return me your money in installments. 1 gold coin a month will do, and then there will be the interest above that as well. Now, interest means the money you pay extra to the borrowed money as long for the duration you have taken that money for. With these words, he stood up and left after threatening those money lender. The scribe, the money lender, left the room. The scribe began to moan softly, means cry softly. His wife sat down suddenly, her knees giving way beneath her, below her, means she sat down. Continuation of the explanation of the lesson will be done in the next video.